We're extremely honored that Revered Swami Pranavananda Puri Maharaj has come back. He came, last time he was here was 10 years ago. And Swamiji, the last 40 years, he has been serving the poor and downtrodden in the Rameshwaram area, working amongst the fishermen, children, women, quite heroically through the Ramakrishna tradition, and also spreading the messages through Ramakrishna, Swami Vivekananda. And we were blessed about 10 years ago, so we spent about a week in his ashram. He showed us really quite the magical environment. You cannot imagine. We're still flying high from that visit so many years ago. So we're very, very, very pleased. As you can see, Swamiji is very enthusiastic in kirtan and service and speaking and every storytelling. He's queen of the area said that he was Swami Vivekananda's chosen fighter. So we have he's hand chosen by Swami Vivekananda. So I believe her words. Swamiji?
I can start.
Yes, yeah. Anything.
This
you're the middle, Swamiji, yeah. Sorry. Yeah, just so everybody can hear. No problem. It's loud, Swamiji, you should not need
level is okay. Sarva jiva pavanasa karanam mageshwaram svikrudancha garbhavasa degabhashamidrusham Yavidam swa lilayacha yena duya jivanam Yavidam swa lilayacha yena duya jivanam tam namami deva deva Ramakrishna Ishwaram Om Stavagaya Chadharmasya Sarvadharma Swarubine Avadara Varishtaya Sri Ramakrishna Yade Namaha. On the first hand, I must convey my heartfelt gratitudes. Namaskaram to Mausha. Mausha. She is not an ordinary lady. Many times Mausha visited Rameshwaram Mandir. I took her all around. So about 15-20 days back, I arrived in Chicago. I am very particular to visit this Kali Mandir. There are so many mandirs in the US, in the States. Some Kali Mandirs are also there, but this is the greatest powerful place. But wherever I go, so they publish some magazines regarding, because I am fighting for the rights of the downtrodden fishermen and afflicted refugees from Sri Lanka, the Tamil refugees. So whenever this Swamiji might have even seen that one. So they have to select some photos. Seeing me that Kali Mandir sitting like that, well, Swamiji, this is the best photo.
Sitting on this seat, throughout, same seat, Swamiji.
same seat. But with tennis. So Swamiji looks Kali, Mother Kali, and your dress and everything, very so something cooperating very nicely. They selected to put on the magazine. It is thousands and thousands copies are sold in Tamil. So that is the greatness of this place. So first, namaskar goes to. Because in 1969, I joined in Ramakrishna Mission, about the Golden Jubilee year. For the 40 years, I am there working there for the downtrodden fishermen. So that one, Rameshwaram is not an ordinary place. Greatest place. And apart from that, I have to convey my namaskaram to. These are the, like that one, for the Lord Shiva, there is Veerabhadra Swami. And Mother Kali also like that one. They are like that one, guarding deities. Like Karpana Swami and all, we tell in Tamil. Like that, they are there. I have to tell my namaskaras apart from all the people assembled here. So not an ordinary day for Anjaneya, Lord Ayyappa. Saturday. So that this thing, very auspicious day. So I must give you some important information on this day. But Rameshwaram is not an ordinary place. There are about 12 Shivalingas in Bharat. All our inspiration, our religious, everything, all these things from Bharat, Kashila. 12 Jyotirlingas they call, installed by sages and saints. Those days, Shankaracharya and all great people like Patanjali Maharshi installed by 12 Jyotirlingas. They are in the south, middle, north and all. Only one Shivalinga, that is in Rameshwaram, was made by goddess Sita Mata. 11 Jyotirlingas were all made by rishis and munis, seers and saints. But only one Shivalinga made by Sita Mata. You have to keep it in mind. So, because mother, goddesses herself made that one. Shivalinga out of sand. That is the thing. And it's such a powerful, even Guru Nath saying, saints and sages, many of it, thousands and thousands of years. Just I shall tell you for your information. Guru Maharaj's father, Chudiram Chattopadhyaya, when he heard about the greatness of everyone knows about Ramayana, he wanted to go visit Rameshwaram. Those days, no convenience, no transport, no proper food and all those. The road also was very rough and tough. Thousands of kilometers from Kamarpukur. You see, straight, this is Vishnu Bhakta. So carrying this saligram and other way, this thing, he walked from Kamarpukur to Rameshwaram. Even now we may not be able to fly in there and all the way. Such a hard task. Months together he walked. Such an orthodox Brahmin, he will take rice and other vegetables from other people, offered, and cook his food and offer it to the Lord, Mahavishnu, then walk all the way. Took months and months together after reaching Rameshwaram. Then you might have seen there are three corridors are there in the Rameshwaram. Main corridor where is Lord Shiva made by Sita Mata. Second corridor, 108 Shivalingas are there. Those who are, they will understand. So those days, Brahmins, saints, sages, they used to come. They used to independently worship that one for 10 days, 15 lakhs. Also. So Guru Maharaj also worshipped that Shivalinga. Worship. Outside, used to go and make offer. Is this thing, prayers to that Sita Mata made by Main Shivalinga. But he used to do that one. Then, after that, walked back to Kamarpukur. A son was born. First is Ram Kumar. Second son is Rameshwar. Third is Ramakrishna. This is not, it's very, very important. And another important thing you must remember, it is closely associated with Guru Maharaj, mother and Swamiji. Swamiji, after the Mahasamadhi passing of Guru Maharaj, he took Guru Maharaj, Sri Ramakrishna, Bhagavan Sri Ramakrishna, became a monk, and wanted to know what is the real condition of Bharat. So Guru Maharaj interested him in some job. You must uplift this Bharat. You have to propagate these ideas of our Sanatana Dharma. So from Calcutta, he walked to Kashmir. And from there, when he started from there, he had two sangalpa. I shall not touch money. I shall not ask food with anybody. Even if I perish, if it is the will of the Lord, I'll complete this yatra, this wandering. It took him 7 years. A great challenge. Without touching money, without asking for food. Swami Vivekananda walked from Calcutta to Kashmir, Kashmir to Cape Kumar in Rameshwaram, Dal Kavaling. Many incidents happen because I am like trying to bring the main point. So I am there for the working for the downtrodden fisherman, very poor fisherman, very afflicted. For your impression, because of this ethnic violence and all, so far 600 fishermen have been shot dead by the Sri Lankan Navy. 2,500 fishermen received bullet wounds and lost their livelihood. This is the condition there. Apart from that, Sri Lanka, more than 25 years was for the Tamilians coming and going, but our Ramakrishna mission conducted a relief camp. So I was in charge of that relief camp. We could help at least 2 lakhs of Sri Lankan refugees. I was personally, day and night I worked for that one. This, now I am also helping this just one. So just one incident, what was in Swamiji's heart that will awaken us. Swamiji started from there. He was walking. From there he was towards the south, he was going in Khetri Samastana. There's somewhere near Rajasthan. Khetri Samastana, one incident happened. It will awaken us. Swamiji was walking and he couldn't get anything that day. Morning, he went to some river, had his bath, and there was nothing to eat. Nobody, he will not, that is his pledge, Sangalpa. Nobody gave anything to him. That he was just, he saw a huge, big mountain there, crossed. No village or thing. Then some, suppose the boys were tending the cattle and all. He asked him, village or somebody is there, Swamiji, you have to walk a long distance, that mountain. If you cross that mountain, there is a city there. City is a small town is there, not city, small town is there. You may get something. So their poor boys told. Swamiji had to walk no proper road and all. So he had to walk such a long, when he reached the top, it was almost evening. Then he climbed down. When he reached the town, outside the town, he could see some mandir. There was some temple was Jain. There was some temple. Then he just went near this Shiva temple. That Pujari was finishing about 7 o'clock, something like that, was about to close the temple. Swamiji Maharaj went there, made namaskar, and the Pujari told Swamiji, this is connected with the Raja of Khetri and all those things. I have to close this one. Swamiji, I'm extremely tired. Just I can lay down, no, Swamiji, no, because so many sadhus, it's not permitted like that one. It was. Then you look like a sadhu. Many people say they are sadhus. I don't know, just put on the cloth and all those things. Some valuable things are here. So I may not be able to accommodate you. Swamiji told, my condition is very, very pathetic. Why don't you relax? Nothing. First, I should know whether because he's a very learned Brahmin. First thing. See, he started putting some questions. How you got sannyasa? What is sannyasa dharma? He wanted to test Swamiji. Swamiji gave exact answers. So he got stunned. Swamiji knows many languages, a manager. There, to see the knowledge of Swamiji, read sannyasa dharma and all those things. God said to Swamiji, you are extraordinary. I am feeling some kind of power in you. You look like a Lord Shiva. Okay, Swamiji, you can stay here, but I can bring some of my friends to there to talk with you. Immediately he went and brought some of the very learned Brahmins. In some places, Swamiji was explaining in English. His Hindi was not that fluent. He was explaining. But then they had a heated argument. So it was going on. They could not imagine such a brilliant sadhu. So many people nearby, the scholars, professors and all arrived there. You could see such a great man have arrived here in this mandir, Shiva mandir. They started putting questions after questions. The news spread. Some Brahmins, highly learned Brahmins, Vedas, mantras, they arrived, started arguing something in Sanskrit. Swamiji defeated all of them. Swamiji in his life history, he says, 3 nights and 3 days, non-stop. People coming in, making namaskaram and all those things, it was continuing. Finally, some very, very important man from the king's court, oh, I heard about the Mahatma, don't disturb him, 3 days over. So you allow him to, he may enter into deep samadhi, super conscious state. Allow him, like that one, come on, go away. All the sent out, he also left. Then Swamiji was just sitting near that. Shiva near, just leaning on a pillar. Then he heard a voice from outside, standing from near the door. Swamiji, just, who are you? What do you want? Swamiji, I am a very, very poor man. 3 days I am struggling. I wanted to have your darshan, which you are not coming out. You are arguing with and all, giving answers to the people. I am from an untouchable harijan, untouchable caste. I should not enter into the temple. If I enter into the temple, they will punish me. So 3 days I am seeing some, no, all of them have there. Can you come out so that I can make a pranam to you, get your blessings? Swamiji told, no problem. Lord Shiva is there, myself is there. Even some problems I can manage. You come inside. So I give you guarantee. That poor old man went. Oh Maharaj, he fell at the feet. Oh Mahatma fell at the feet. And looked at Swamiji. Swamiji, what do you want? He started weeping. Maharaj, what happened to you? Maharaj, just you are very, very tired. I'm an ordinary man. I can feel my heart is beating. I think you have not taken anything. Nobody gave you some food or anything, did you? Feel, I see my heart is beating. Swamiji, I feel with the motherly heart say, did you eat anything? Swamiji wept, Vivekananda. So many people came. Professors came, argued. All so-called Brahmins came. They also argued. Even landlords and all, they problems of your family, you have to solve. Oh, Mahatma, you have to solve our problems. But nobody asked him whether you have taken food. 3 nights and 3 days. Then Swamiji wept and told, there is in our Veda says, what it says means, Ishya Saha Brahmani Charadi Saha Brahmanaha. Who is a real Brahmin? Who can understand, who is always close communication with the Lord? He alone is a Brahmin. Not that I am doing puja, I have put on malva, sacred, not that. You should have that real feeling, Brahmacharadi, one who has can't direct Bhagavan Guru Maharaj, only worshipped Mother Kali had the vision. He never touched money. What is happening? Present times, you go to the, even you use puja reserve, what are they for money? And all those things. They never think about the Lord. The same thing in India also. That is the condition. So we say, then Swamiji says, this man, poor man, by seeing that he could understand my feeling, was all. Who is a really a learned man, professors arguing with him. What for we are getting education? To help others, to serve others, to remove the ignorance of others. But they were putting, never asked, Swamiji, did you take some food? That is the mind of the people. So many landlords and all, jamins came. They wanted blessings to solve their own family problems. Then Swamiji felt, here is a Brahmin, this fellow, untouchable. Here is a learned man. By seeing me, who could understand my problem. He is the richest man. What are you going to do, Swamiji? Swamiji, I have got some food there, but old food, and that only we eat. Shall I bring that food to you? For that much only, it is late in the night. Some, you may be a pure vegetarian. I can, some onions and chilies are and all there. That old food is there, which was cooked in the noon, for the lunch, that choked in the water. Swamiji with pleasure, he told. I'm burning with anger. He brought and fed that Swami Vivekananda. Then Swamiji feels and tells, so the neglect of the masses is the main cause for our downfall. India lives in the huts. Next day, Kaitri Raja himself arrived there. So he was taken in a palanquin. He told he would help support this gentleman, give him house, water, the facility. This is one example. Like there are so many examples. After that means he walking from there and asked to miss many examples. Swamiji reaches where he reaches Rameshwaram. Through the coastal area, Thiruvananthapuram and all, say he reached Rameshwaram. There was also, he was almost like a beggar that time. So he was going, many of you might have visited Rameshwaram temple. So he was going and sitting there in deep meditation. Some of the Satris and Brahmins, generally Tamilians are very highly learned, Satras and English knowledge also. Though he is giving food. And the Swamiji, where from you come? Then he started explaining them in English. They saw such a knowledge in English. They got astonished. So then many people came and started arguing with Swamiji. They got stunned. Swamiji, we have never seen a sadhu like this one. Here in Ramanathapuram, the Raja of Ramanathapuram. He's a highly learned man. He's a great scholar. He studied in some Oxford somewhere. Why don't you go and meet him? Though from Rameshwaram, about 10 days Swamiji was there. From there, Swami Vivekananda walked to, because main point I am going to bring you, he walked through, went to Rameshwaram, 60 kilometers he walked, reached the court, king's court. That time some settlement was going on. Bhaskara Sedupathi king was sitting there. When Swamiji entered, all got up. By seeing his personality, pages, all got up. Swamiji, so please sit down and all. So Mahatma, where from you are? I am a wandering monk and also. I like to meet you and also. So quickly finished, then he started. Swamiji, did you take some food? No. If you offer, I can take. So take it, then he started chatting. And seeing the brilliance of Swamiji, he got stunned. So he was also very learned. But then he told that, king told Swamiji. So arguments was going on. Then he told Swamiji, I have an invitation to go to Chicago. The original invitation was for king of Ramanathapuram, Bhaskara Sedupathi. So the British people selected me to represent the Hinduism in Chicago. Their religious conference is there, world conference. I have been invited to go there. When I seeing your knowledge, your experience, your religious thing, tejas, I feel, if I am like a candle, you are like a burning sun. You are a burning sun. My going is useless in front of you. So I endorse this to that you will attend that Chicago conference. Because the original invitation is for the Raja of Ramanath. So he handed over that one to Swami Vivekananda. Swami Vivekananda, so I am traveling there to us. I personally have no way. Whatever divine will, accordingly it will happen. From there he walks to Kanyakumari. When he walks to Kanyakumari, you might have seen that beautiful rock there. That time it was cyclonic season. So it was hitting waves and nobody could go there. Swamiji went and made namaskar to Mata Kanyakumari there, Devi. And he said, I'd like to go and there, meditate there. He felt restlessness. He, with one cope in lion cloth, he swam. 3 kilometers he swam and got there. And 3 days and 3 nights he meditated. There he got all the realization how Buddha had his realization. Under the Bodhi tree, Swamiji had that realization. And there he says many things, but the poor, the fallen, the downtrodden, let these be our God. Service to them is the highest religion. Then Sri Guru Maharaj appears and as if walking on the sea, you have to go abroad. Then returning, he walks to Chennai. Swamiji walks with him. After that one, he goes with great this thing. very another important thing was, that time his family was in a very, very tragic condition. His father, Vishwanath, was a great advocate. He died. He had two sisters. Swamiji's sisters were there. What did you see? Sisters. Some of because so much of loans he took and nobody to help them. Somehow they gave them marriage. So when Swamiji was wandering in life, they were given to marriage. But what if they couldn't pay the proper dowry? Swamiji was in Bombay about to get, then he gets a telegram. Two of your sisters committed suicide. They were sent back to their home. But Swamiji wept and wept. That is Vivekananda. You are seeing one side of the coin. Others. Two of sisters and two brothers were there. Never married. Entire this, they when he hit Swamiji wept. Two of sisters died. And he wept and wept. So that Turiyanji Maharaj went there before saying, Swamiji, like that you are selected for this purpose. So we are very happy to represent. Not that one. Lenten Brada means, I am going there, if you can, it is in the Belur Mat record. I was in Belur Mat. There, by selling my knowledge, whether I shall be able to do something for these poor people. You see, what happened to my sisters, those who carried me and all, they committed suicide. So with the heavy heart only he went there to Chicago. Then after the greatest victory, he was supposed to return back to India. Then he himself selected Rameshwaram. The great invitation in Calcutta, Bengal. And the invitation in Chennai, the boys, the one, Khetri Maharaja. But he himself selected, I shall go first, make namaskaram to Lord Shiva. He arrived in 1897, 26th January. Swamiji landed there. And Raja created a great welcome thing means. So that there is now, they built, central government built, spending 2 crores a memorial there. And we reached Rameshwaram. First lecture in Rameshwaram. Address which is inscripted on the wall. He says, it is in love that religion exists, not in rituals and ceremonies. It is not how many times you enter to a church or a mosque or a temple. How much you feel for others. You have seen Shiva in one poor man and served him. You are 100 times entering the temple and the rituals doing is equal to that. That message Swamiji preached. So even now that is the message for the entire Bharat, I tell you. Preach after that one, great reception and all those things, then went to that another, when after reaching, meet Mother Sharda Devi. Before going also, he took the permission for going to Apran. Then he told the greatness of Mother. Sharda Mata kept in her mind. She felt she should visit Rameshwaram, which is very, very important, because we are sitting at the feet of Guru Maharaj, Mother and Swamiji. Sharda Mata wanted to, in the meanwhile, Swamiji passed away to 1902. That was there. She told, then Ramakrishnanji Maharaj, 1910, he made arrangements. Big reception, made arrangements. Sharda Mata, Gola, Mahayogin Manda, all reached Chennai. From there, they were taken by train to Rameshwaram. When the Rajas, that time Bhaskara Sedhubadi passed away, his son was Rajeshwara Sedhubadi was there. When he had, so his father used to tell, that is Guru Mataji. Swamiji Vivekananda is my guru. So he made elaborate arrangements to see Holy Mother. Sharda Mata went there. And when there is a tradition in Rameshwaram temple, in all the Jyotirlingas, Adi Shankara installed most of the Jyotirlingas, that Kedarnath only Kerala Brahmins are worshipping. And like that in Maharashtra and all different places. From North India, that Maharashtra, like that one. Omkarnath and Sri Shailam and all, interlinked that one. In Rameshwaram presently also, only Maharashtra Brahmins can enter into the sanctum. Not even Tamil Nadu Brahmins cannot go there, even presently other situation. That was so authentic, the tradition. So the, even now, the, only Maharashtra Brahmins, Barve, they are all doing puja. So when Holy Mother arrived, the Raja was there. He arrived and he felt some kind of inspiration, some power. He called all the Brahmins to come out. Never happened in the history of Rameshwaram. We all must know. Ask them, request them, you please come out. They made about 108 golden vilva leaves. Generally, the vilva patra, we offer the ordinary one. Golden vilva leaves. And he told, Ma, you enter inside. Mataji, you can do puja. So Sarada Mata started doing Om Mageshwaraya. Brahmins were repeating the mantra, 108 golden vilva leaves, even though that is there in the temple. Belur Mat wanted to take that one, instructed that work for me. Mother offered, that time what happened? She had a vision, mother. Suddenly everything, so she had a vision. She cried, I see the present Vichaila you left thousands of years back. It is not in some Bengali book, it is recorded. In our Tamil book also, it is recorded. She just cried that Yogi Man, Ma Ki, no, don't disclose this one. She often, she felt she has become like Mother Sita. So Ramana is real, because after Mother Sita, no lady entered there. No lady entered into the shrine. First in Nerchi Sharada Mada. Ramayanam, everything is true. Sri Puru, Bhagavan Ramakrishna is none other than Bhagavan Ramachandramurti. So that is the greatest theta. Why I am telling you, you see, with so much of love and affection, I offered some nice sugar candy there before coming here. I am distributing everywhere. So before going, that sugar candy, which where Sita Ma worship in front of that Shivalinga, I kept Vibhuri and Kungumalsa, because the Brahmins are greatly attached to me, that I brought for you. So Maharaj will distribute that one, that you have to take and receive the blessings of the great Bhagavan Ramachandramurti, Sita Mata. Today is special for Anjaneya. That is my prayer and all those things. Maharaj, what is time?
Right now it's 8 o'clock, another half hour
or something? Just few, one instant from the life of Holy Mother, I feel like telling. Because I am serving the most downtrodden people with great difficulty, opposition, but somehow I am managing for the last 40 years I have managed them. So what I mean in the life of Holy Mother, one instance, you should all keep it in your heart and try to do something for the such people, if they are somewhere near, somewhere in our place or village like that. Sharada Mata, after Swamiji's memorial, they built a nice house for her. There in Calcutta, they built a nice house for Holy Mother, and she was honored like a deity. So it was going on. So every day, many people want to come worship Mother as a living Durga Devi. So Durga Puja time came. And there was nearby, there was some slum area, something like that. So many people are going making namaskaram. There was one very, very poor, this thing, girl, lady. So lost her father and with some few, this sister, somebody is there. You might have heard, it's very famous. Her name is Sarala. She saw so many people are going. The condition of, he was making some stitching, something to earning. So this helping the family. I can also go to Mother Sardas. They said that she is the incarnation divine. She also went there, made namaskaram. And she started weeping. Mother Sharla asked her, what are you? What is your name? Sharla, Ma. I am staying here because I am very poor family. Can I do some work here? So those said, I gave some food and other things for my mother and all. Mother got system, very nice, my daughter. You are most welcome. Very near, Ma. I can come and do some. During my leisure time, I do some stitching and other things I can manage. Can I help here? Yes, Ma. You are most welcome, daughter. So every day she used to go and do some work there, cleaning the vessels, washing the glass and all. She was continuing that one. So nice. So whatever food remaining and all, prasad and all, she used to give. Oh, the family was so happy. That time Durga Puja came. That time. So great arrangements were going on. So gradually, to Mother, they wanted to worship her like a she. The final day was there. Say they wanted to decorate Mother, offer Mother everything. Sarala could see. So Sarala told Sharadama the earlier day, so much of crowd will come. You should be with me. You have to help me. Tomorrow morning at 3 o'clock you reach here. So that you can, otherwise night overnight you stay, we shall go there and all. Then Sharala saw, so everyone is bringing some presentation to Mother, offering it, very costly saris and all. She felt, she says, my daughter. Daughter must give something. So went to the house, she got only hardly some 3 or 4 rupees, something like that only, her entire this thing, savings. So with that she went to, those days, she got a very ordinary cotton sari. I must offer some vastra to Amma. So, in between the crowd, she also stood. She kept it and the Mother just looked at her. She laughed. Why do you bring us, Mother? I must do so because everybody is worshipping like Durga Mata. So, it's a small offering. That's all. Like that, my mother also told me to offer something. So, with Susan. Over. So, she stayed there. Early morning, Mother got 2:30 like then. Let us go to Ganges. So, Sharla, you come now. Some few other ladies also followed them. So Mother had her bath, returned. And she told, Mother was sitting with the wet sari. Come on, bring some good sari for today. Then what happened? The ladies were there. So the volunteers were there. They brought nice 3,000, 4,000, like the Swami Ma. This is looks like Durga Devi's file. I don't like this. Throw it away. One, two, everything was rejecting. Ma, what is this? So it's already more than an hour, you are shivering. Sarala brought something, you bring that sari. Sarala wept, Ma. No, this last is more, so many people, bhaktas are going to, you should not wear that. No, it came with so much of love and affection. This Durga Puja, I shall wear only that. Ma, don't talk, bring that. They have to take below from that one. Then Sarala plunged, made Sankalpa. My whole life I am going to dedicate for Mother. For me, nobody in the world. She is my everything. And she became the first president of Sharadamat. She came to abroad also, preached the teachings and also a little learner. See, with such guts, when she saw Mother putting that ordinary sari, she had, she showed, my whole life is offered to Sharada Mata. That is the real love of our Guru Maharaj, Mother and Swamiji. We have to imbibe something in our heart, not just hearing that for them. To such people, that is the most important thing. For the last 40 years I am doing there, amidst of so much of oppositions and all those things. For your, this thing, for information, I just tell you, there were about 10 lakhs of fishermen in Kanyakumari district. 10 lakhs of fishermen. Presently, not even a single Hindu fisherman in Kanyakumari district. 10 lakhs have been converted. Then, so 71% Christians, for your information. So we have to, and you should know the other side of the coin. 24% Hindus, 5% Muslims. Yehi paristhiti hai Rameshwaram mein, Kanyakumari mein. Seeing that only, Swami Ranganathanji, I went and told him, Swamiji, so there was a big problem, even ferry was stopped. Then what is the condition, Ranganathanji Maharaj asked me, it's a great soul. So Rameshwaram is safe, enter into the battlefield. No more, not even one, since this is our Sanatana, not only sitting and coming and making bhajan. Can you take up that challenge? Yes, Maharaj, I am duty, sir. So whether you live or die, that should be in the land of Rameshwaram. But you work for that one, downtrodden people, without disturbing your Christians or Muslims. You are the follower of Guru Maharaj. There is no difference, but you have to save them. So with the help of Swami Ranganatha and Marai, that institution started. I am there working for the Raplin by the grace of Guru Maharaj. This Bhagavan says in Bhagavad Gita, Ananya Chintayantoma Ye Janaga Parivasade Tesam Sadada Yuktanam Yogachemam Vahamyaham. With single-minded devotion, if you do my duty, all your requirements I bring it to a door. I never make an appeal. I have no cell. I have no email. When I just started that institution, practically I had nothing. That Bhagavan Ramachandra Murthy, your footsteps trodden here. Sita Mata made Shivalingam out of the sand. And Anjaneya Bhagavan dedicated his life from here only the all. And Guru Maharaj's father, sages, and if I am a real sadhu, you should bring everything here for me. So that is continuing. Why I am seeing those days, rishis and munis, how they lived and how they worked. They never had all any external. But you have to develop that spiritual power. If you have that son, you can face anything in the world. Even if the whole world opposes you, you will win in there. Mother Kali is with you. You will win. Even if the world wanted to lift you up, if her daya is not there, everything will, with no time, will be finished. So this is my message, a humble message. So we all depend upon Mother Kali. This is great, greater. I cannot explain in words. This I am giving this message in the front of the Mother Kali. So I pray for you. You also, instead of donating money and all, you sincerely pray for the welfare of all those afflicted people. And more than money, that, this and all, the prayer will keep me alive. I shall fight till the now. I am about 72 years old, fighting there. For this, we all pray for your welfare. Pray to Rameshwar Shiva and all those things. You all pray for the welfare of the many those afflicted people. Jai Ma, don't forget to take the prasad. Okay? Jai Sri Guru Maharaj ki jai. Jai Sri Anjaneya Bhagavan ki jai.
Jai. Very fine, Swamiji. Perfect message.
What came from the heart speaks to heart better than any language. Yeah. What in my heart, I am not a lecturer, I am a learned man, professor, nothing. What came from my heart, I conveyed this. Jai Ma.
You can take this one.
So I am everywhere distributing. And this is offered in the shrine there in the Shivalinga. Jai Ma. Sundaram, Sandaram, Rumba Nanda Padre. Brahma, we're too angry.